we are going to start today's motion. Yes, motion as such is not a new topic to you, but before going to the definition and further about motion, first I want to give you a quick idea what are we going to learn in this chapter. Yes, it's not a small chapter, it's a quite big chapter, and there are very many important concepts. I'll be starting from here. So your first thing will be your motion. So the definition of motion and the basic what is motion, that we'll be discussing first. That will be followed by relative motion. What do you mean by relative motion? Yes, that is not a critical thing, but it is, you have to understand what is the difference between your motion and your relative motion. So next,
ma'am, your voice is cracking.
My voice is cracking.
Yes, ma'am.
Still cracking, ma'am.
Still cracking.
Ma'am, when you are speaking like this, it is clear, but when you are talking, means you are taking your headphones near to you.
So, I think internet connection is a little problem. So, 1 second. So up to from describing motion in every topic, you have numerical problems. Uniform motion, non-uniform motion, speed, velocity, acceleration. Based on this, you'll be having many problems. Next will be your graphical representation of motion, where you are going to understand how to draw the graph for distance, time, and velocity, time. And the last and the most important part is your equations of motion. You are going to derive the equations of motion. It's an almost a compulsory long question in any exam from now. So your seniors have lost marks also in the same topic, equations of motion by graphical method. Okay, so these are the contents which we are going to study in this chapter. So each and every topic, it seems to be easy, but it will not be easy, because whenever he is going to ask the numericals, you have to understand the question and solve the numericals, which is not that easy unless and until you concentrate and understand the topic. Clear? In the 8th grade, we have only one formula. Yes. Pressure is equal to force by area. For that only, we have, many of you have done mistakes. Not many of you, some of you. Yes? Is Kani here? Yeah, including him. Okay, next one. So, what are we going to understand today? We are going to understand what is motion and what is relative motion. If time permits, we'll also see what are scalar quantities and vector quantities also. Yes? So, first we'll start with the basic, or the introduction for this chapter now, what is motion and what is relative motion. Yes, we'll go. So first, what is motion? So this is the basic definition. I don't say it's a definition, it's a description. Exactly what is called motion. Yes, an object is in motion when it is continuously changing its position based on a reference point. Yes, so what is this reference point? I'll tell you. And as observed by a person or a device. So, for example, imagine you are standing on a road. Yes, imagine you are standing on a road. So, when you are standing on a road, suppose a bike is moving in front of you. So, you will be the reference point here. Yes, you will be the reference point here. You will be standing in front of your gate, observing the movement of the vehicles on the road. So, you will be the reference point here. And when the bike is moving in front of you and it is moving away from you, yes, initially it was in front of you, later it is moving away from you, means the bike which has started in front of you is continuously changing its position based on a reference point. Here, you will be the reference point. Yes, you are the reference point. For you, the bike is changing its position continuously. For example, now it is in front of you. After a few seconds of time, it is at the end of the road. So it is changing its position continuously based on the reference point. And as observed by a person or a device. Yes, imagine you are standing at the starting of the road, your friend is standing at the end of the road. For you, the bike is moving away from you continuously. Yes, for your friend who is standing at the end of the road, for him, the bike is coming towards him continuously. You are understanding? So your perception of motion changes according to the person here. Yes, the perception will change for you, the perception will change for your friend. Yes, for you, the body is moving away from you. For your friend, the body is coming closer to him. Yes, so the motion will depend on the reference point or the person observing the motion. Yes, it will depend on the person who is observing the motion. So a car from one place to other, the car is moving from one place to other. So the car is in continuous motion. Or else I can simply put that we can say that a body is motion if it is continuously changing its position with respect to a particular point. Yes, a body has to continuously change its position with respect to some point. Then you call it as motion. For example, you are playing carrom board. Yes, you have hit the striker. The striker will change its position according to your force. Yes, that is the motion. According to your force applied, the body is getting movement. Yes, how is the body moving according to you? Or how is the body changing its position based on the point which you have taken is your motion. Yes, if you ask in the exam, define motion, then what will you write? We say that an object is in motion when it is continuously changing its position based on a reference point. Or it is continuously changing its position based on the person observing it. Yes, it has to continuously change its position according to the person who is observing it. Yes, so this is basically what is motion. You will define it in a very simple words. A body is in motion when it is continuously changing its position based on the reference point you have taken. Clear? If you have any doubts, you can ask me. Yeah.
Can you explain the friend example which you give? The friend standing on the end of the road.
Okay, Shifal, I'll come to it once again. For example, you are standing before your gate. Yes, your street is little long street. Your other friend, for example, friend Y is standing at the end of the street. Yes, imagine your father has started the bike in front of your gate. Yes, for you, your father is moving away from you. Yes or no? So according to you, the
Ma'am, gone. Your voice.
Can't
hear
you.
Not able to hear you.
Ma'am, you're
hanging. And our video is also lagging.
Lag.
We can't.
I didn't get you.
Ma'am, you are stuck. Now it's okay, ma'am.
Now it's okay.
Again, it's getting stuck.
Yeah.
How can you go a bit closer to the Wi-Fi router?
Okay. Yeah. So if
hello, ma'am. Ma'am.
Hello, ma'am.
Is it clear now?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, Shifal, I'm coming to your example again. Okay. So, if you ask your friend what is the motion of your father's bike, then she will be saying your father's bike is coming towards me. Yes. The body change. For you, it's coming close. For you, it's moving away. For her, it's coming closer.
Guys, are you hearing that?
But the object is in motion because.
Ma'am, your voice is cracking.
Yes, ma'am. My internet is not good.
Ma'am is just stuck in one picture.
It is continuously changing its position based on the reference point. Yes? When you take.
Ma'am, we can't hear you.
Yeah, we can't hear you.
We lost, ma'am.
We lost, ma'am. Is that a word to say? We can't hear.
We lost
half of the time got wasted in this all.
Hello, ma'am. Can you hear us?
Ma'am's video is stuck in one place.
Ma'am, I understood only till motion.
Yeah. Is it clear now?
Yeah, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. That is about the definition of motion. Shefali, is your thing clear? I just want to say that if you are the reference point, you will explain it like that. If your friend is a reference point, she will explain it in her perspective. Yes. So what I meant to say that it will change according to the person's perspective. So, next one, this is the types of motion with examples. We are not going to study any of these things in detail in this chapter because this is a quick recap of what you have studied in your previous classes. The types of motion with examples. Yes, so vibratory motion, linear motion, curvilinear, all these kinds of motion you have studied in your sixth grade. Yes, so there is a quick recap of the different kinds of motion. But in this chapter, we are going to see only about your linear motion, circular motion, that's it. So these are the main types of motion which are going to
see. Recap of vibratory motion.
Yes.
Ma'am, can you like...
Yeah, I'll quickly go through all these types of motion.
Ma'am, do we have circular motion?
You have circular motion, Tarun. Okay, but whatever we are going to study, uniform and non-uniform, that is which will come under linear, that we are going to study in detail. Yes, all the remaining things we are not going to study in detail. Circular also, you have a small subtopic. Okay.
Then what time is chapter 10 to end?
I'll be a little louder, Aditya.
Nothing, ma'am. Just like that.
Okay, so first one, vibratory motion. You say that a body is in vibratory motion when it is moving to and fro. Yes, the to and fro, continuous to and fro motion of a body is called your vibratory motion. This motion should not be new for you because you have seen it even in your 8th grade in your sound chapter. Yes, difference between oscillatory and vibratory also you know. When a body is moving in to and fro motion, it is oscillatory. If it is quick to and fro motion, very quick to and fro motion, then it will be your vibratory motion, which we have seen in sound chapter. Yes, linear motion, we are going to see in detail when a body is moving in a straight line. Yes, when a body is moving in a straight line, we call it as linear motion. Curvilinear motion, when a body is moving in random directions. Yes, it is not moving in straight line, then you call it as curvilinear motion. Circular motion, when an object is moving in a circular direction. Yes, we can take your rotation of your earth as an example. That is your circular motion. Any object which is moving in a circle is termed to be in circular motion. This we are going to see in detail with the formula. Yes, next and the last is your rotatory motion. Yes, rotatory motion, when an object is rotating around other object, you call it as rotatory motion. For example, planets rotating around the sun. Clear? So this is a quick recap of the different types of motion. There will not be any question based on types of motion. You don't have types of motion for grade 9. We are going to study the linear motion in detail. Clear?
Ma'am, I have doubt.
Tell me.
What exactly is the difference between circular motion and rotatory motion?
Very good question. Aditi, if the earth is moving, yes? Rotatory motion is around its own axis. Yes, rotatory motion is the motion around its own axis. For example, you spin a ball. Yes, when you spin a ball, the ball spins around its own axis. Yes, then you call it, if it is spinning around its own axis, you say it is rotating around its own axis. Yes, for example, you imagine your friend to be at center and you make a circle, you move in a circle around your friend. Yes, then that motion of yours will be the circular motion around your friend. Yes. For example, you are rotating yourself. For example, if we are standing like this, you are moving like this. You are rotating around your own axis. Yes, then that will be your rotatory motion. You are rotating. You are standing and you are moving around. Yes, you are moving 360 degrees like this. Then you say your body is rotating around its own axis. Yes, imagine you take a chair and you make a circle. You move in a circle around that chair. Then I will say you are in a circular motion around that chair. Yes? Take that particular chair, catch that particular chair in your hand and rotate that chair 360 degrees. Then what you say? You say that I am rotating the chair. Then you don't say I am circulating the chair.
So circular motion is ultimately an object moving around a fixed point.
Yes. Yes, a fixed point or yes. So the you can make this simple example. I am rotating the chair around at an angle of 360 degrees. I am saying I am rotating the chair. I don't say I am circulating the chair. Yes, the same chair. For example, your group of friends are standing in a circle. If you play passing the parcel in the same chair, then I can say I am circulating the chair. Yes. It is changing its position in a circular direction with respect to a particular point. Yes? Imagine your friend is at the center. All your friends are sitting at the circle. You are playing something. You are circulating something in a circular direction. You are passing something in a circular direction. Yes? That is the basic difference between rotatory motion and the circulatory motion.
Musical chairs.
Yes, musical chairs. Yes? In musical chairs, there is no rotatory motion. If the person is moving around like this, then you fall. The person is basically in circulatory motion. Imagine when you are playing musical chairs. You are at the center, Shefali. Yes? So, the person who is moving around will be in circular motion to you. Yes? Unless and until you are moving in this angle, at an angle around yourself, you don't call it as rotator. Yes, rotator is moving along your own axis.
Ma'am, so it's like rotation and revolution
yes,
of the earth.
You can apply the same thing here. Rotation, when earth is under rotation, earth is moving around its own axis. Same thing you apply for anything.
Yeah, yes. So when it's rotating around its own axis, it's rotation. And when it's revoluting around the sun, it's circular.
It's circulation. You can put it somewhere. For example, planet Mars. Yes, planet Mars is circulating around the sun. You can put it like this. Yes, planet Mars is rotating on its own axis. I can't say planet Mars is circulating around its own axis. I can't put it like that. You understand? Whenever you are talking with respect to other thing, planet Mars is circulating around the sun. That is right. Planet Mars is circulating around its own axis. You can't put it like that. Okay, planet Mars is rotating around its own axis. Yes. Same with a spinning ball. Yes. Or the spinning top. Take a spinning top. It is in rotatory. It is rotating. It is rotating around its own axis. Okay. Clear with the difference? Any doubts? And in the same way, you have to understand the difference between oscillatory and vibratory also. Yes. For example, you take a pendulum. Pendulum will be in slow motion to and fro. That pendulum motion, you should never call it as vibratory motion. Let me make you very clear. Yes, pendulum motion, you can't say it as vibratory motion. One more example. Take a rubber band, stretch the rubber band. Stretch the rubber band and ask your friend to disturb it from the center. So now I can call that as vibratory motion. Because when you stretch a rubber band and you disturb it will be in continuous oscillation. That you can call it as vibration. Yes, that is a quick oscillation, quick to and fro motion will be your vibration. Be very careful with the difference. Okay, that you can't call it as oscillation. Stretched rubber band, if you disturb it, that is not your oscillation, that is your vibration. Clear? Take a thread, take a string and tie a ball and disturb it, it will slowly move to and fro. That is not your vibratory motion, that is your oscillatory motion. Clear? So first, curvilinear, there are many examples. There are many examples. You playing in a playground is curvilinear motion. You fighting with your friend is a curvilinear motion. Any random motion is curvilinear motion. Yes? So clear with types of motion?
Yes.
Linear motion, don't worry. That only we'll be
Mom.
Doing. Yes.
Ma'am, this is Leticia. Actually, is a parabola type of curvilinear motion?
Leticia, parabola is definitely a curvilinear motion, but that doesn't mean that only parabolic motions are your curvilinear motions. No. Yes, that doesn't mean only parabolic motions. Yes, anything which is other than linear, you can put it as curvilinear. Okay, anything which is not linear is curvilinear. Don't be under the impression that as I have shown in the picture, only this is your curvilinear. No. Yes, if for example, if you are moving in a random direction like this, the way is like that. For example, you are going on a bike, which is in a crowded street. In a crowded street. There you are not taking any parabolic motion. No, right? But you can't call it as linear motion because you are not going in a straight path. You are moving in a random path. Though it is not parabolic, I should call it as curvilinear only. Clear? So don't be under the impression that only the parabolic path is your curvilinear. No. Any path which is not linear or any path which is not moving in a straight line or straight path, you can put it under curvilinear motion. That is the reason I am saying any random motion which you do is curvilinear motion. Other than linear. Yes? So don't be in another misconception looking at this picture. Okay. Any random motion is your curvilinear motion. Except linear, everything is curvilinear. Okay. I'll ask you something. Now, is your vibratory motion a curvilinear motion or a linear motion?
isn't that completely different?
Yes. So that's the reason. So when I'm talking about types of motion, these categories, put it as separate only. Yes, don't try to categorize vibratory, oscillatory, circular and rotatory under linear or curvilinear. No, these are special types of motion which we are going to study in different. Okay? So, clear with the types of motion is only for your understanding. No questions from this topic as such. Okay? Next one.
Ma'am, if I drop an egg from a height, which type of motion is it called?
Tarun, come again. Is it Tarun?
Yeah, ma'am.
Yes, Tarun, come again.
Ma'am, see, if I drop an egg from a height, it's moving. So, what type of motion is it?
You're dropping an egg from a height.
Falling motion.
It should be linear. Because your object is coming down, it will be coming in a linear motion because it is only under the influence of your gravity.
Okay.
Yes, there is no other thing which is going to disturb your egg.
Yeah.
Yes, so it is, you have dropped it, it is coming.
Ma'am.
Yes.
I'm a ma'am. But the egg will break, right? So which kind of motion is it?
Yes, Aditya, come again.
But the egg will break, right? So what kind of motion is it?
Aditya, egg breaking or egg becoming an omelette is not our concern here. Our only concern is egg falling from your hand and coming down is only the concern. You are going in a linear motion on a road. Either you meet with an accident or you fall down is immaterial here for us.
But we'll still get a loss, right? So what kind of motion is it?
Aditya, our loss and profit is not the case here. For example, you are going on a cycle on the road. There is no disturbance.
Don't fall down.
No, 1 second. You are going on a straight on your path. You are going in a straight line. You are going in a linear motion on your cycle on the road. Yes. Imagine you are in some other world. You are thinking about some cartoon or something. You went and suddenly hit to a wall and you fell down. That doesn't mean that it is not a linear motion. Up to reaching that point, you are in linear motion, right? So you will be in linear motion only.
Ma'am, one more question.
Yes.
Ma'am, if I drop an egg weighing 100 gram from a height of 1 meter, can I find...
From a height of?
1 meter.
Okay.
Can I find the time it will take to fall without actually dropping it?
Tarun, come once again.
Oh my god.
Oh, ma'am, someone is drawing, ma'am.
Ma'am, we are playing Holi in the screen. Yeah, someone.
Okay, it's fine. Yeah, tell me, Tarun, repeat your question.
Ma'am, I take an egg weighing 100 grams. Okay. I drop it from height of 1 meter.
Okay.
And I want to measure the time it will take to fall down without actually dropping it.
Without actually dropping it? Absolutely, you can do it. Why not?
Okay.
You can do it. You have your formula S is equal to ut plus half at square. That formula will come when we are deriving the equations of motion. You can definitely find out.
You should find out
the time. You can find it out very easily if you know the distance you are covering and at what speed you are dropping it. If you know those two, you can calculate. Clear? You can calculate, and you will calculate also at the end of the chapter. You have to calculate. You have no other option.
Yeah.
Okay. Any other doubt? Yes. Yeah.
Ma'am, what is V is equal to U plus AT?
V is equal to U plus AT is the first equation of motion. We are going to derive them. You have to be a little patient until we come to the equations of motion.
Ma'am, can we please move with motion and it is relative?
Yes, Shefali, but let me make it very clear. What are you saying? V is equal to U plus AT. All these are equations of motion. We'll definitely do it. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, we'll go step by step. That will be more better. Yeah. Next one is motion is relative. There is some picture moving here for you.
Yeah.
Yes, there is a girl sitting on, there's a parachute moving up. Your concentration should be only on the motion of them, nothing else. Yes, so remember this picture, I'll come back to this picture again, okay? So before going to that, why I'm saying motion is relative? Yes, what do you mean by relative? Yes, what do you mean by relative?
Ma'am,
you tell your meaning.
Relating an object to some other object.
Very good. Relating an object to some other object. Very good. Any other answer?
Ma'am?
Hmm.
Ma'am, there are two motions which are relative according, actually respecting the surroundings.
Very good. So what do you exactly mean by relative means with respect to something. We are explaining the motion with respect to something. Yes, so I can put it very simple. For example, you take your relatives. Yes, with respect to someone, your relation changes. The person will be same with respect to the person. The relation changes. The same thing you apply here. Relative motion means with respect to something. Yes, the object is moving with respect to something. That is your relative motion. I can't say something is moving. We have to tell with respect to which object it is moving.
And can you give an example?
Yes, Alcha.
Can you give an example?
We'll be doing many examples. Okay. Right. First, try to understand the concept that here we are going to explain the motion of a particular object with respect to a reference. Yes. What is that reference we are going to see now? Yes. Now you can see some pictures here. This person who is standing here will be our reference point for us now. The man who is standing in the court here. Yes, I have taken a graph kind of thing. Don't worry much about the graphical representation. That is only for the understanding. Yes, so your zero, your point of intersection of x-axis and y-axis, that is, yes, point zero. Here, the person is your reference. We are not going to draw any graph. Don't put such kind of expressions. Okay, this is your reference point. For this person, we are going to see now. He is our reference point now. Yes, I am reading once, go through it. Man is standing at ground, observing airplane or moving car. Man is standing. Okay. Hence, its coordinate is not changing its position. This person's position is fixed. We are not changing his coordinate. Mm-hmm. Yes. But every time the coordinate of airplane is changing and hence, airplane is moving reference frame. Now, here our concentration is only about relative motion. You don't worry about the reference frame, inertial frame. Not required. According to your syllabus constraint, that much information is not required. Okay, what is the inertial frame? What are the coordinates? That much information is not required. What you need to understand here is, with respect to this person, the plane is moving. With respect to this person, the car is moving. Yes, with respect to this person, these two are moving. Clear? With respect to this person, when he is looking up, the plane is moving. That car is also moving. Now, think in another perspective. Okay, now he is our difference point. According to him, these two are moving. Now think about a person who is sitting in the plane. Yes, now you are traveling in the airplane. Imagine Aditya is in the airplane. Yes.
Yes,
I
want to dice that many times, ma'am. Please take some.
Yeah. Okay. So, according to this person, the plane was moving. No, for the person, I take person X. Archa is feeling bad. I take person X. Person X who is sitting in the plane. For the person who is sitting in the plane is not moving. Yes, or he is not moving. Yes, Shefar, I'll take your example. It will be more better. Yes, Shefar, you are sitting in the plane. You are sitting in the plane. For you, you are not moving. Yes, you will be doing your work. You will be sitting as if you are sitting at your home. For you, you are not moving. But for the person, for the reference person who is standing here, all the people in the plane are moving. So whenever I say plane is moving or the people in the plane are moving, it is with respect to this particular person. Can I say this is a relative motion? The motion is relative. I can't generalize a statement that Shefali, respect to this person, only the plane is moving. So whenever we are asking about the motion of the plane, we have to say that the plane is in motion with respect to this person. That is your relative motion. With respect to this person, only the plane is moving or the people in the plane are moving. With respect to this person, only the person who is wearing red shirt here is moving. For this person who is very active in the car, for this person, he is not in motion. Yes, but for the person who is standing out, this person is in motion. So with respect to the reference point, you have to tell the motion. Relative to this person, they are moving. Relative to this person, only they are moving. For the people sitting in that vehicle, they are not moving. Relative to the person standing outside only, it is moving. That is your relative motion. Yes, I have taken few more examples for relative motion. I think we don't have time now. We'll be doing it in our next class. Some train examples. I have taken some pictures and some videos. So we'll be doing in the next class all these examples. So till now, if you have any doubt, we have seen only the definition of motion. So initially, we have seen what are we going to study in this chapter. Next, what happened, Shefali? So next we have seen what is the definition of motion. The object is said to be in motion when it is continuously changing its position with respect to the reference point. That is your simple definition. Any example you can give. There is no rule that you have to give only this example. Any example of your choice you can put here. Yes, we have seen the types of motion and the little differences in the types of motion. Yes. Next, we have seen that motion is relative. We couldn't see much examples. We will do this picture also. Yes, we'll be seeing what is the relative motion according to the woman sitting here and the man sitting in this train. Okay, all these things we'll see about the solar system. Why are we calling this to be relative motion? We'll see even this with the scalar and vector.